The United Kingdom says it's fast-tracked a coronavirus vaccine, which will be trialled in humans from tomorrow.
First clinical trials are underway for a vaccine candidate for coronavirus.
And if we really want to get back to normal, a coronavirus vaccine is the holy grail.
Clinical studies play an important role in drug development. Many people don't know it, but making a medicine is a long, complex, and costly process that can take even up to 15 years. And in human trials, there is even a possibility of side effects, and not all clinical trials are successful. Welcome to Scientific Engineer, and in this episode, we'll discuss lab on a chip and its possibility of how it can be used to speed up the process of developing COVID-19 vaccine. When a drug is developed, there are two methods to test it: cells in dishes and animal testing. Further, the drug is put up for clinical human trials. In conventional cell culture, cells are grown at the bottom of a dish, so they are flat and spread out in two-dimensional. But if we think about our body, we are not flat and two-dimensional. Again, there is animal testing. Many of these animal testing don't even predict if the drug will work on humans, which can lead to drug failing in clinical trials and cost an average of $2.6 billion. So you might ask, how can this lab on a chip help in speeding up the process for vaccine development of COVID-19? For that, we must first understand the working of this chip. These microfluidic chips are kind of like chips in computers, except they use channels to process fluids. Microfluidics is defined as the manipulation of flow of very small particles of fluid within channels in the micrometer. Further, this microfluidics can be applied to develop lab on a chip. A lab on a chip technology makes it possible to conduct miniaturized lab analysis on micro or nano scale. The chips can vary in size from a few millimeters up to a few square centimeters. Lab on a chips contain channel structures and have one or more laboratory functions built in. Research and studies have shown that the coronavirus infects our respiratory tract. It travels down our airways. The lining can become irritated and inflamed. In some cases, the infection can reach all the way down to our alveoli. If only we could make artificial replica of a lung to test drugs, then it would drastically speed up the process of drug development. Waste Institute researchers and a multidisciplinary team of collaborators have engineered microchips that replicate the microarchitecture and functions of a living human organs, including the lung. They call it a lung on a chip. Let us understand what is a lung on a chip. It is an artificial lung that we want. This is manufactured by techniques of the computer chip manufacturing industry to make a structure at a scale relevant to both the cells and their environment. This device mimics the mechanical and chemical functions of a living, breathing lung. There are three fluidic channels. A porous, flexible membrane separates two channels at the center of the device. The opposite sides of the membrane are lined by human lung and capillary blood vessel cells. And we can then apply mechanical forces to the chip that stretch and contract the membrane, so the cells experience the same mechanical forces that they did when we breathe. Then, air flows over the top of the lung cells, and the liquid medium containing the human blood cells flows below the capillary cell layer. We can then introduce bacteria in the lung channel to mimic an infection, and we introduce white blood cells through the blood channels. We see that the white blood cells migrate across the capillary cell layer through the membrane into the airspace where they interact with bacteria. Here you can see the live simulation in a magnified view showing the migrating white blood cells making its way through the membrane. And this is the fundamental response that our immune system exhibits. The great thing about organ-on-chips is that you can work on the actual mechanism of how this drug works in humans, as opposed to working on a mouse and then finding out that it's different on humans. And that can help in speeding up the development of drugs and identify problems with them much earlier, This is crucial today in the time of corona outbreak, where researchers are still using animal and human trials. And let me impress you with this one more thing. In the future, it could be your cells on the chip. Because everyone is different genetically, their environments are different. So we can have a customized drug designed for ourselves. This can revolutionize the entire drug industry. What do you think about this? Make sure to leave your opinions down below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Happy sciencing!